Hey, this is Avicii. We were here in my studio in Stockholm. I started on a remix a while back for a friend of ours. I haven't been doing many remixes lately, but I really like the vocal on this one. It's from Eric Turner, the guy who sang with Tiny Tempo on Written in the Stars. And I already began on a version, but I'm not really. I like the actual melody, but I'm not very happy with. I'm not very happy with the arrangement and the bass and the mixing or anything, so I'm just gonna try and take the melody out and try and start redoing it from scratch. So I'm just opening up my old my old file. This is the melody, so I'll just copy that and do a completely new one. And I just downloaded actually a new plugin. So it's not a new plugin, everyone's been telling me to get on it forever, but I just actually got around to actually buying it, and it's been it's been amazing for me. It's just so easy to work. Like, I'm all about, you know, trying for me to, I have to get started quickly and have to get into it quickly, so the easier it is for me to then I can do the rest of the sound, actual sound engineering and playing around with the sound, I can do afterwards. But just to get into it, it's really cool to have a plugin that's easy to play around with. And Silence is super easy, and like a lot of presets sounds really good and stuff like that. Just double checking to see that it's the right. Yeah, a little bit too fast. Okay, cool. Yeah, so what I need here is definitely need to do some layers for the top melody and for the
So you kind of start with everything on piano and then start sort of slicing up the bits of the piano and assigning them to other instruments.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. So like if I would have this and if I would want to keep on playing on this or whatever, then I would still have this like this, and then just keep playing if I want more top melodies, or if I want an arp, I'll just do it in the piano. Like that on top of it, and then I'll just like bring out the layers and everything afterwards. So I'm just bringing out one of the layers, and I want to go with something kind of obnoxious, something kind of in your face type sound. And I think there's a couple in here as well. Okay, that's why. Okay, yeah, so I'm took the wrong amp. There we go. This should work. Okay. I know I want something a bit like high, but I'm not really sure what exact sound I want to use. So I'm just looking around and see if something sounds like it. And then Nexus is good because I know Nexus in and out, so I know almost all the sounds in there. So if I want something for reference, it's really easy to me just to look it up here. Cool, now I have the melody and I'm just gonna try and bring in, obviously not the right sound just yet, I'm just gonna try and bring in the vocal as well to see that, that it fits with it. Sugar caught me by some- cool, so and when I'm working, I'm usually like just, I use this Kajir hose. Actually, I got this as a tip from Layback Luke, and it's just a one knob master limiter, and I just kind of put it to 0 dB, and then I just kind of push everything all the time, and then I'll do everything, like go in and fine tune everything. It's easy to work like that as well. Then I could bring in a kick as well, in the, and then I sample all my I've gotten a lot of samples from other producers, and for me that's been like all forever since I started. It's been so hard for me to find like good kicks, and it just does the whole world when you get a good kick, and it just helps you with your spirit, because then you, like you, if you have a good enough kick, just the kicks itself sound good. So. Okay, cool. So now what I'm gonna try and do first is gonna start off with where I want it to be when everything is in, like at the absolute core, at the absolute end of the track. Start off with this and see if this is enough for a bass. I'm guessing it probably is. Then I'll try and sidechain it a little bit. And in FL, I use the P control to sidechain. There's no compressor, no professor shit going on in here, as Axwell would say. So. Try and do a different side chain for the rest of the instrument, just because I like having the bass duck a bit more than the rest of the synths. I don't think I want a piano for this, so I'm gonna try and something with a bit more electronic. The reverb and stuff, and try to put that after the sidekick, so to get the reverb not ducking. And I usually use a lot of, it depends on what, but just for synths and stuff, I usually use a lot of FL's. I use FL's own. If I don't want a fancy reverb, if I don't want a fancy delay, I'll usually use FL's own stuff for the reverb and delay. This is good enough to start with. Now I'm gonna try to start like arranging the track a little bit. And then I think I'm gonna try and start with some kind of arp for this one. And a beat in the beginning. And I used to play around with a lot of loops and stuff as well. And layer the loops and try to remove like the stuff I like from one loop, and you know, and see what fits together.
Are these loops from?
They're from everywhere. I've got in loops from all my producer friends, and you know, I've bought loops. It's from everywhere. This is one of the things I really like with FL, is that once you get a loop in, you can just, like, you can press the middle mouse button and it just kind of, like, switches the loop. and then you can go through all of your loops to the left, and everything is just super. It's just really quick, like everything is so quick in this program, it's insane. I'm gonna try and get another kick. Kinda like this kick. I'm thinking I'm gonna start with having the kick low cut it in the beginning. Didn't really like this loop either. I kind of like the groove of this loop a little bit. I think it needs something more after a while as well. Okay. And when I work with loops as well, this all changes. I might like suddenly when I'm done with the track, just go in and switch out all the loops just because I'm not happy with it. It's just easy for me to get into the groove a little bit when I'm sitting, like when I'm just starting out. Okay, I'm gonna try and start with something a little bit, something with a note in it in the beginning as well. Hang on. I kind of like the sound of this a little bit. And then I'm gonna try. Yeah, and for white noise and stuff, I've just from all of the samples I've gotten from all my friends and stuff like that, I really know exactly where to go and what I want for regular white noise, which is also like the same with because effects is something that's really hard as well to find good, really good effects, and I'm pretty lazy, so it's always been hard for me to like go in and do my own effects. So now I probably have, like, I know exactly if I want something like this as well. I do white noise from synths sometimes if it's something that the audio can't do. But I'm usually working from audio, yeah. It's the same with drums, it's all sample-based for me. It's so much easier for me to work. I haven't really found a VST or an instrument that I enjoy working with for drums, for instance. And that's the way I've been working, like, right from the start as well. So it's hard to get into, like, oh no, instruments are not for drums. VSTs are not for drums. I'm trying to find, looking for like a light bass, nothing heavy at all, just something. Actually, if I pull this one. And I'm the worst organized producer in the world, I think, as well. Because in FL Studio, you assign your channel, your instruments and FX and stuff to your channels by yourself. And you just always push it to 12 and then push that one to that. I never name anything, so I never know what the fuck I'm doing, but.
Low-cutting the bass there.
Oh, sorry? Yeah, I'm just low-cutting the bass because I don't want it to... I just want it to have it as a groove in the beginning to go with the high synth. Yeah, I do it now when there's no bass involved. I'll do reverb on just because to have it. Yeah, I've been taught no reverb on bass ever since I started on Levex Loops forum. And yeah, no, I just find it like when it's low cutted, it adds a little bit to the atmosphere, I found. But not a lot, just a little bit. And then I know, like, I'm gonna need an FX here by the 30-second mark, and I know I'll need an FX here and there. But that's more like I'll save that for later. So then I'll just kind of start getting at least after the first drop, and then when I'm there, I start working a little bit there, and then I know where to go with the second part of the track as well. Well, no, I think I'm gonna bring in the vocal in the first breakdown at around like 1 minute or something. Around here, I think. And then I'm not gonna have it like this. Because I don't want it to compete with the vocal, so I'm gonna try and do it a little bit like longer chords instead. Yeah, there's a couple of things in this program that I wish was here, like you could just make everything the like
also, yeah.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. And I might try strings for this one actually, from Contact. That was gross. There we go, legato cello. Yeah, I've never been very technical at all. I've always been very much more about. Like it's taken me forever to learn how a compressor works. Take me forever to learn how everything works. I've been always more like if I tweak this, it sounds good, and if I do this, it sounds good. I've always been more like that. Yeah, and then I'm gonna try and filter it down a little bit. Just because, yeah, it sounds a little bit too movie music at the moment. There's one thing as well, like if I'm doing strings or instrument that sounds more acoustic or whatever, it's then I usually don't use the FL Studio Zone, then I go and like use the wave stuff and stuff like that. Sugar caught me. Yeah, I think I'm gonna remove the space. It sounds way too too evil to go into those strings. I'm gonna try and maybe bring the strings up instead. Yeah, this is the automation in FL. So this is, I'm doing an automation for the strings, volume and the filter. And I'm just bringing it up for the breakdown. Actually trying it in, take a sweep. This is what I mean, like this is just a regular like white noise sweep, and it's so much easier just boom like that, and you have it done already, yeah? And then if it doesn't sound good, well, obviously we're gonna have to go in and make it sound better later. But just for arrangement's sake, it's so easy to work that way. We'll be right back. Fill or something there. And then when I'm arranging it with the FX and stuff as well, it's more like pointers to me to go back to. So I know that okay, over here I'm gonna need like a or something like that. Down the sunset, up the lights. Try and do a this again, yeah. I'm just gonna do a simple delay now, a quick one, just for the vocal, just for the transaction, obviously. Just the EQ I used in the beginning for the gig. I actually kind of liked it starting like that. If I low cut the bass a little bit. want it a little bit more, like, a little bit more crispy. So I have this thing called glitch, which is basically like it has all of these effects and stuff. I'm just using it for the big crush right here. But it's really cool if you want to do like glitchy electro and stuff like that, because it has like a randomizer and all that shit. So it's really fun to play around with. So here, like, it gets like that crispy, really crispy sound. But yeah, not really automation, I just kind of changed the lead. Just the sound of the lead. It was way too, a little bit, it was conflicting too much with the rest of the sounds, I think. Well, I'm just in the middle of actually just trying to just finish off the whole arrangement, because then I usually finish the whole track and then I kind of go in and fine tune everything afterwards. So like right now we're at 2:30, and I usually do so I'm gonna try and do there we go. So now we've gotten to the second break right here. And then
do you layer kicks?
I don't layer kicks, no. I've done it, but I just feel like I've gotten so many good samples right now that I'm just not talented enough to actually layer it that well, like engineering wise. So like the kicks that what I do now though is some kicks tend to sound better. I just say if you cut the low of the kicks, some kicks sound better and some kicks sound worse. So that's why I kind of use two, one a little bit heavier for when everything hits, and then one when I just want a low cut of bass.
So instead of layering, you use one for sort of certain parts of the arrangement and another.
Exactly, yeah, but still close enough so you won't really hear, okay, that's another kick. So it's going to be, you know, you're not going to tell the difference, hopefully. I'm trying to figure out to do like a small bridge to the break, and then this is a second breakdown. So I'm trying to figure out how to do it.
Would you say that these are pretty much all the elements you're going to use in the track? Is it in terms of...
No, that's what I'm trying to figure out right now. I think I want to bring in something else for the second break. Something like a little bit longer, like, let's see if I can find it. Something like that to have in the background, just in the kind of transition to the second breakdown or whatever. I'm not even sure yet. I'm playing around. And I never record it directly in, so I just kind of figure out what I'm gonna do, and then I'll try and, you know, just draw it in the piano roll afterwards. Something really weird with that, like something, you know, that sounds something completely different. I'm just trying to figure out how to do this, because I don't think this is going to work with the vocal. Oops. Yeah, I definitely want to use this somehow, but I'm not sure how I'm gonna bring it in right now. So I'm gonna keep on doing. I keep on doing the arrangement. I think I want the vocal to come in here. I'll mute that. Thinking about doing something fancy, but I'm not afraid to And I'm trying to think of where to go from here. Yeah. Tuned all the automations for all of the cymbals and the snares. It would be cool to have something with like a little bit more saw, like a saw waveform instrument, See if this works first before I say anything. Yeah. actually going to do it really quickly. I'm actually going to put reverb and filter automation on the master.
Is that something you often do?
Well, I always do it first if I want everything, but then I always end up going back and have to change it because there's something that's not going to be, you know what I mean? But I just do it first because it's so much more, it's so quicker than, especially here in FL, because then you have to do all the different buses and everything, and you have to, it really, like, it takes so much longer. No, I'm trying to figure out. No, I was gonna do with that one, but I think I'm gonna try and find another sample. I want something to go to pitch up, like something similar, but not, because I want this in the background as well as a harmony. Okay. Feels like it needs something more.
The rising part, was that just automating?
Oh, which one?
The little.
Oh yeah, no, okay, yeah, I pulled out a just a sample. Let me just see if I can find it. Yeah, here, like this. Like that, and then I just pitched it up.
Automated that.
Yeah, automated the pitch up. Just really, it just adds, like, it's become kind of like a little bit of signature of mine. I just always, I heard, like, someone used it way back in like an old track, and I heard it sounded so, like, and then I just got hooked to that as well, and I try and do it like usually like now I'll put this one in here like that, but then I'll go back to it and switch it up and maybe change the rhythm and try to do it afterwards. But as I said, I'm just trying to finish the actual arrangement first. Like right now we're at 5 minutes.
So So this is the big drop now, really?
This is the big drop, yeah, that's what I'm trying to make it. Yeah, and it's not big yet. It's big, but come here. Something was wrong, Hannah.
What was wrong? Tell us when you
No, I was actually wrong. There was nothing wrong. Well, so obviously something is wrong if I think it's wrong, but I'm trying to figure out what it is. Then again, I'm gonna try and do something like a really easy drum loop or something to begin with, and then you know, redo it later. It's just so much easier for me to work when the arrangement is all done, and I can just focus on actually. Focus on the little things and stuff like that, because otherwise you feel like, okay, it's not done yet, so I can't focus, I have to finish, you know.
Do you find that more difficult as you get more experience? Because you get more hung up on the sound?
Yeah, definitely. Way more difficult. Exactly. Exactly.
Not ruining your creativity.
Yeah, and it's super dangerous as well. It needs to be bigger. I have a lot of like, especially Nexus is good to have like instruments underneath that you don't really want as your lead, but you want it kind of underneath just to build, and to give it some more room or to give it more punch or this and that.
So do you use it more like sort of building blocks kind of?
I do now, yeah. Yeah, before I used to use it more as a, like, yeah, more as my main VST or whatever. I had a couple that I use, but right now I'm mostly using it for, just because I've gotten so tired of the sounds, you know. But I know that they're like, I know what they're good for, and I know where to kind of like try and use them. Like this, you don't really hear this, you know what I mean? It just kind of just melds together with the rest of it a little bit.
So would you say this is the usual way you work, is in like lots of sort of?
Yeah, lots of layers. A lot of layering on the actual with the synths. A lot of layering, just because it really gives it that. Well, it depends on what you're doing as well. But if you want to make a track big, layering is the best way. don't really want you to hear the piano either. I just want it to be kind of like there in the background. So that now I have basically have the whole arrangement set up. So like from here, I just start going into all the specific with everything and start the mixing and start doing like those kinds of stuff.